Mistake number two, nutrient burn. When it comes to feeding cannabis plants, many growers fall into the trap of thinking, if a little fertilizer is good, more must be better. But over-fertilizing your plants can be just as harmful as underfeeding them, and nutrient burn is the all-too-common result of this well-meaning mistake. Nutrient burn occurs when plants are overwhelmed by an excess of nutrients, particularly salts, which accumulate in the root zone and disrupt the plant's ability to function properly. Fortunately for growers, the symptoms are often easy to identify. One of the first signs is burnt leaf tips, which turn brown and crispy as if they've been scorched. This discoloration often spreads to the edges of the leaves and can be accompanied by yellowing or blotchy patterns on the foliage. Over time, affected leaves may curl or even die off completely. So how can you prevent and fix nutrient burn? The key lies in moderation and understanding your plant's needs. Always start with a lower nutrient dosage than recommended, especially if you're using a new product or growing a sensitive strain. Experienced growers will often opt for feeding at half the manufacturer's suggested strength to gauge their plant's tolerance, and only then gradually increase the dosage once they have observed the plants responding positively. If you notice signs of nutrient burn, it's essential to act quickly by flushing the soil. This process helps to wash away the excess salts and restore balance to the root zone. Flushing a cannabis plant involves thoroughly rinsing the growing medium with plain, pH-balanced water to remove excess nutrients, salts, or buildup. To flush, slowly pour enough water through the soil or hydroponic system to allow runoff, which is typically 2 to 3 times the volume of the pot. To make sure the flushing process is working, growers will use an EC meter to monitor the runoff's pH and electrical conductivity levels. And that's a wrap on today's episode. Whether you're dialing in your setup or just getting your hands in the soil for the first time, remember, growing cannabis is a journey, and every small improvement adds up to bigger, better results. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and make sure to drop a comment below. I'd love to hear your story and what techniques have worked best for you. Your insights help fuel this community and shape future videos. And if you want to dive even deeper, consider becoming a Cannabis Guy channel member. You'll unlock access to monthly giveaways, exclusive content, loyalty badges, member-only discount codes, and much, much more. It's a great way to support the channel, stay informed, and grow right alongside an amazing group of cultivators. Thanks for tuning in to this educational video. And as always, keep being awesome and stay curious, my friends.